station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Leah Cheshire. The space station freed up one more parking spot this week with the departure of Northrop Grumman's Cygnus spacecraft. After 109 days aboard the space station, Cygnus completed its 11th commercial resupply mission and was released by NASA's Nick Hague. Upon its arrival on April 19th, Cygnus delivered nearly 7,600 pounds of research and supplies to the orbiting laboratory, including experiments studying vascular aging in astronauts, a tool to more easily analyze biological samples in space, and a few free-flying robots called AstroBee. Though Cygnus is no longer attached to the space station, its work is not finished yet. Once Cygnus reaches a safe distance and higher altitude from the station, it will use the Slingshot deployer to eject a series of nanosatellites. It will also be evaluated by an external, free-flying robot called Seeker. Seeker will take images of Cygnus and perform attitude maneuvers to demonstrate its ability to operate safely around another spacecraft. Afterward, it will be commanded toward a disposal trajectory, leaving it to burn upon re-entry to Earth's atmosphere. After a few more months of system tests, Cygnus will also be destroyed upon atmospheric re-entry. This week's question is from Alex M., who asks if Cygnus can boost the space station before it returns to Earth. As Alex noted, some spacecraft have the capability to boost the space station or raise its altitude while still attached. This keeps the space station from having to use its limited fuel supply to stay in orbit at about 250 miles above Earth. Cygnus has been tested for and can provide a boost to the space station if required, but most altitude adjustments are made by the Russian Progress spacecraft or by firing the thrusters on the Russian service module Zvezda. Keep sending in your questions using the hashtag AskNASA. We'll see you next week.